Hello and welcome to Fear the Alien. My name is Michael, and a few guys asked me about my hot wire cutter and the materials I use, so I decided to make a video for you guys out there from Google Plus and here on YouTube. The hot wire cutter I use is called ThermoCut and it's from Proxon. I recommend this hot wire cutter because it has some features you can't build by yourself, like this movable guide rail that you can loosen and tighten with a screw. You can also change the position of the rail by moving it to the other side. The wire is with 0.2 mm extremely thin. The spool of the wire is tightened on the top and it's also movable. It has 30 meters of wire, so it lasts very long. Sliding the spool to the side allows you to make diagonal cuts. But you can also make cuts with a precise angle by adjusting your angle and moving the rail with the piece to the side. This feature allows you to make nearly invisible edges. Using two wall pieces with a 45 degree angle cut is always better than using two pieces with straight cut, because you always will see the straight line on the side. When you turn on your hot wire cutter, you can adjust the temperature of the wire. The temperature here really depends on the material you use. If the wire is too hot and you are not moving fast enough, you will see it, because it will melt your material away. When using the hot wire cutter, you can always make templates out of cardboard. The wire will only cut through the material and not through the cardboard, so you can use your template again to make the exact same tile twice. The aluminium surface of the hot wire cutter measures 390 by 280 millimeters. With its on-printed scale, you can measure things very fast and the pieces glide very well on the surface. So now let's take a look at the materials I use. Most of the time I use the pink insulation foam and sometimes the white stuff that comes with packages, but I also use a gray indoor insulation foam called Klimapor. The thickness of this stuff is 4 millimeters. I found this stuff in the wallpaper section of my hardware store. It's very flexible and lightweight, so I used it for my ground plates. It can hold a whole bunch of demons without bending. But when it comes to the heavy 360 grams Black Dragon, it bends a little bit on the sides. Most of the time this should be okay, but if you wanna boost this material, you can put some cardboard under it or use plywood as a ground plate.